Bonjour, class. Hello, class. Madame just finished working out, and I just felt so incredibly lonely. So I thought that I would send you a video of the workout, and you guys could work out at home with your parents, or your siblings, or your cousins, or your aunts and uncles, or your grandparents, whomever's at the house. Say, hey, let's go work out, and drag them along to do this workout. Okay, so here it is. 15 seconds of jumping jacks, 5 push-ups, 15 squats, 15 curtsy lunges, 15 arm cross-arm crunches, 10 knee push-ups, 15 seconds side planks, and 15 seconds long arm crunches. I'm going to show you how to do each exercise, and then I'm going to leave the workout to you guys. The first one is jumping jacks. How I teach my students to do jumping jacks are étoile, soldat. Étoile, star. Soldat, soldier. Étoile, soldat. Étoile, soldat. 15 seconds of those guys. Then we have push-ups. When we are doing push-ups, if you cannot do them on your feet, then you can put your knees down. So make sure your arms are shoulder-width apart. Stretch out your legs. You do not want your bum in the air, nor do you want it sinking down. You want a nice plank position. When you are going down, make sure you go all the way down and all the way back up. All the way down and all the way back up. If you need to drop to your knees, then drop to your knees and do the exact same thing. All the way down and all the way back up. When it comes to squats, you want your feet shoulder width apart, okay? I'm going to turn sideways so you can see this. You do not want your knees going over your front toe. You want to take your bum and you want to push it back like you're sitting into a chair. All right, let's try this. Push it back and then squeeze it at the top. Push it back, squeeze it at the top. When you're doing curtsy lunges, you're going to again take your feet shoulder width apart. You're going to take your one leg, bring it far back, and diagonal behind you, straight down with your knee, and this knee does not go over your front toe. Again, take it far back, drop it down. Do the same thing to the other side. So it's going to be 8 and 8, that will make it 16, but at least we have even on both sides. All right, then we have cross arm crunches. I'm going to show you both of the crunches at the same time. So the first one is cross arm crunches. Cross those arms, keep them tight to your body. Make sure you have a mat or something if you're on the ground and it's not a carpet, just so that you can not hurt your back. Okay, so keep those arms nice and tight to your body. Do not crank your neck, try and keep your neck in line with your shoulders, and you're gonna crunch up using your abs. Exhale, and back down, nice and slow. And down. Long arm crunches, your arms are overhead. I put them together. And again, do not use your arms. Try and use your abs. And exhale when you go up. Always keep controlled movements. Do not go fast. Keep it at a nice pace. And do not use momentum. Last one is side planks. You're gonna do this on both sides. So use again a pillow if you have to, or a rug. Get that elbow underneath your shoulder, stretch out your legs, and then lift your hip. Keep your arm on the side and hold it here for 15 seconds. Go to the other side, do the exact same thing. Now, if any of this is too easy for you, you are more than welcome to add weights. Madame uses a weight vest. So when she's doing her lunges or curtsy lunges, she has a little bit more weight. You can also use weights in your hands. Please do not give children weights. They shouldn't be using weights until they're 13 years or older. All right, please have fun working out, and I will see you guys all soon. Mwah. Au revoir, goodbye.